In this scenario, you animate an object and apply Snapshot to create a ghosting effect as you learned earlier. What's more, you learn to animate the visibility of the clones to create a true ghosting effect with the clones appearing one after another. You start with a non-animated scene named CarSimStart.max. The idea is to animate the car getting out of control and hitting a post. You could animate the car by keyframing it, but it's so much easier to run a dynamic simulation. Right-click an empty area of the main toolbar and select the MassFX toolbar. Before you start specifying dynamics objects, you need to initiate the car motion and skid before you let the simulation take over. Select the car and enable Auto Key mode. Go to frame 20 and move the car and rotate it so that it skids towards the post. Go to the curve editor and set all keyframes to linear tangents. There shouldn't be much acceleration or deceleration happening at this stage. Scrub or play back the animation to see the motion between frames 0 and 20. Exit Auto Key mode when done. The idea is to let MassFX take over to create the animation after the impact. For that, you need to define the objects to be included in the simulation. With the car selected, assign it as a kinematic rigid body from the second flyout button. Use the kinematic body type for an object that is already partially animated, as is the case here. Now select the post and assign it as a static rigid body. As the name implies, a static body is one that is included in the simulation, but is not supposed to move under impact. Next, click the first button on the MassFX toolbar to bring up the tool's dialog. This is a simple simulation and should not require extensive setups. Select both objects and go to the Multi-Object Editor, the third tab on the tool's dialog. From the Physical Material presets, choose Steel. This affects how objects react based on properties like mass and friction, among others. You could edit those and create your own presets, but this will do for now. Now select the car on its own. The rigid body type is set as kinematic, the way you defined it. However, you still need to specify when the simulation takes over the initial keyframed animation. You keyframed the animation earlier to end at frame 20. You typically want the simulation to take over a few frames before that. Enable the Until Frame option and specify frame 17 as the frame when MassFX takes over. Run the simulation to watch it unfold, and then click the same button again to stop the calculation. It is possible that the car goes through the post at this time, depending on how you positioned it at frame 20 earlier. If that's the case, you need to increase the simulation calculation steps or even sub-steps so that it is more accurate. Reset the simulation. Go back to the first tab, World Parameters, and increase the sub-steps value to 2, and try again. This should work better, although you may need to reset the simulation and slightly adjust the position of the car at frame 20 to get a better effect. Reset the simulation and go to frame 20. Enable Auto Key, move the car slightly, and disable Auto Key again. Run the simulation again. Keep on fine-tuning the solution until you get an effect you like. Once you're happy with the animation, go to the second tab, Simulation Tools, and click the Bake All button. This bakes all simulation into keyframes for related objects. This means that you can now dismiss the MassFX Tools dialog, the MassFX toolbar, and you can even delete the added modifiers to the car and the post. As you play back the animation, you can see the car skidding into the post. Save your work. In the next movie, you create the ghosting effect.